Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. In today's video, we are going to go over how to create a function block for your third-party device using IFM Sensors function blocks in CODESYS. So, let's get started. So here in our CODESYS program, you can see the IFM Sensor function block. This is a generic function block that allows you to pull in your third-party device's process data. In this video, we are going to show you how to make a custom function block for your third-party device as an extension of this generic sensor function block. Now that we already have our two function blocks set up, let me show you how we got to this point. If you right-click and select Insert Network, it will give you a new rung that you can drag your function block into. On the right-hand side under your toolbox, you will drag in a general box function block. And then within the box, if you click on the question marks and on the three dots to the right, you can then select the sensor function block out of your IFM function block library. Once you press Enter, you will then point your master one cyclic data at the IO-link master variable, as well as enter the port number that your third-party device is connected to. I'm now going to delete this rung because we already have this function block created. And if you go online and log in, you can see the vendor ID and device ID of your third-party device being pulled in. And if you go up above and drop down your third-party sensor information and go down to your process data output array, as well as your process data input array, you will see the raw values of your third-party device being pulled in. Now that you have the raw data from your third-party device being pulled in, let me show you how to make a custom function block for that data. First, I need to log off. You are then going to go over to Application and right-click and select Add Object. You will then select POU, and you will give this a meaningful name, select function block, and select your implementation language. In this video, we use structured text. I'm not going to save this because we already have one created. So let me take you into the valve output function block. As you can see above, this is an extension of the IFM generic sensor function block. And by using the super command that you see here, it allows for us to pull all of the data from that IFM generic sensor function block, such as the master cyclic data, the port location, diagnostic data, such as vendor ID and device ID, as well as all of the process data. You would then look at the IODD mapping of your third-party device in order to manipulate that raw data and get it into something that is usable data. As you can see here, we did it in our structured text below. So now let me take you back into our program and show you how to add the custom function block we just created. If you go back into your program, again, you will right click and select Insert Network. And then in the new rung, you will drag in the box. Within the three arrows within the box, you can select the three dots to the right. And this time, instead of going into your IFM function block library, you will select Application, and you will see the function block you have just created, and you can click on that and hit OK. And once you press Enter, you will see all of your variables. Here in our function block, you can see we have declared an input and output variable based on the IODD mapping. So now let me delete this because we already have it added into our program. And if I go back online, you can see all of your data begin to be pulled in to your customized function block, and it should map the data, and it should match the data in your IFM generic sensor function block. So now let's test the custom function block we just created. Up above under the expressions, you can expand your custom function block. You can see that it is currently set for 350 as the valve position. In the prepared value, you can enter a new value, such as 375, and then you would toggle the enable from false to true. Then you will right click and select write all values. And now you can see in the function block below, it has set the 375 as your requested value, and it has changed the valve position in your output variable. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on creating your own custom function block for your third-party device in CODESYS. As always, you can check out our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.